Okay, now after we have completed the modeling phase inside ETABS, and as I have mentioned before, this building is now ready to be analyzed, let's proceed to the new things that we need to do. If I go here, I have saved this model here inside this folder called Structure Model IG. We need now to save this ETABS model into this new folder. Okay, and I will provide a new name here. And as shown here from the folder's name, I will use three models with different stiffnesses. And of course, at the end, we will obtain all the results from those three models into some of those Excel sheets, okay? And now we need to start with filling the first Excel sheet. And of course, I will provide you with all of those Excel sheets at the end of those tutorials. Not now, of course, because we need to fill those sheets step by step, okay? And starting with the first sheet, I will talk today about the development of response spectrum curve according to ASCE. Also, I will show you step by step how to develop those spectrum with different damping. I have already talked about those stuff inside one of my previous uploaded video on YouTube. I think the video is called Defining the Design Response Spectrum. Now let's go to this Excel again. Also, we have imported this design response spectrum in the previous video into ETABS model. We have imported this design spectrum that corresponds to the 5% damping ratio. If I put the mouse here to those cells, we can check that there is no formula inside these cells. And this is because that I have copied those values from the TI code directly. They provide the response spectrum acceleration parameters in the form of a table. Also, there is two tables here. The first one is for the damping ratio of 2.5% and the second is for the 5% damping ratio, okay? Also, as shown here, there is 10 rows and that's because the Bangkok site of Thailand is divided into 10 zones. We are designing this structure in ETABS to zone number 5, okay? Therefore, we need to copy the fifth row of this table. And that's actually what I have did. I have copied those values from here and from the above table into this Excel sheet. But we need to use just this red bold line, okay? And if we are interested in developing the design response spectrum according to ASCE, we need to do some calculations, actually. I have included here in this Excel all the required informations that we need to know in order to develop this design response spectrum. And actually, the first thing that we need to determine is those two factors, the SS and S1 and the cyclic class, okay? Can determine them actually from ASCE, but the problem here is that those factors are just for the United States of America. Therefore, if you are working for a different country, you need to go to your building code country and determine those factors from the code you are working in, okay? But you can follow the same procedure as ASCE. Let's assume now that we have SS and S1, we need to determine FA and FB. Those two factors are just the site coefficient parameters. They dependent on the SS and S1, okay? And we need to do sometimes interpolation to determine these values. I have right here a formula that can do the job for us. And after we determine those two factors, now we can determine SMS and SM1, SDS, SD1, and all of the other parameters, let's say. We need just to follow this procedure here to determine SMS and SM1. We need to use those two equations. The SDS and SD1 are just 2/3 of the SMS and SM1. We need at the end to obtain those parameters to sketch this curve here. As shown here, we need T0, TS, TL in order to determine those three periods. We need to use those equations here shown here in this figure. Also, we need to understand that, for example, for period between TS and TL, we need to determine it from this equation, and for period greater than TL, we need to use this equation here, okay? And that's all what we need to know in order to develop this response spectrum curve. As shown in this table, for period equal to 0 second, the equation used is 0.4 multiplied by SDS, which is obtained from this equation here. Of course, for TS, it is SDS, and for periods between TS and TL, we need to use the equation shown here or here. What I have right here in this function, if the period is smaller than TL, use the first equation. and if it is greater than TL, then use the second equation shown here. Okay, and what we have did now is developing the desired response spectrum that correspond to the 5% damping ratio. But what if we want to obtain it for 2.5% damping ratio? We can follow the procedure of ASCE 4113. As shown here, there is just one additional formula, and there is here a beta factor, which is the effective viscous damping ratio, okay? Going back to here, the beta is 0.025, or the damping ratio. Computing this equation, it will lead to this value. Then what we need to do is just to divide the acceleration obtained by this value, okay? Let me show you just here the formula above if you want to copy it. And at the end, we will obtain the desired response spectrum for different damping using the equation in ASCE 4113, okay? Lastly, let's jump into the defined response spectrum function inside ETABS. We have already imported the desired response spectrum of Bangkok side of Thailand. But the one thing that I want to do here is to convert to user-defined, because as shown here, the text file is still linked to the structure model IG, while I have saved this model into a different folder called Anucrag 0.7 IG, okay? Therefore, we can just convert to user-defined, and that's all for this design response spectrum. Also, since I have changed the name of this file to 0.7, while till now I have didn't change anything related to the stiffness modifiers of those members, I aim in the next video to teach you in detail the meaning of those stiffness modifiers, okay? Therefore, stay tuned for my next video.